This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on the Lord of Pestilence from Avatars of War. Got a little bit of work to do on the model today. What I'd like to get done today is this sort of thing on the model's back. These skulls and these branches or limbs that are actually holding them in place. And if we have time, after that I'll start base coating the actual armor and everything of the miniature, because I believe that's probably where we're going to go next. That's going to take the majority of the time. But for right now, let's jump in and start working on those skulls, first of all. I want to do the skulls first instead of the wood, namely because if I were to do the skulls second, and I happen to dry brush some of the skull color onto the wood, it's going to be a little lighter than the wood, and so it's going to look a little weird. But if I get a little bit of the wood color onto the skull, it's going to be darker than the skull, so it'll just kind of look like shading. It's not really going to make that big of a deal, or that big of a difference. But hopefully I'll be able to avoid it altogether and won't have to worry about it at all. That's the ideal situation. And you can see I'm getting already this base coat from my bone color all over these little spiky bits of the wood, but I'll rebase coat them prior to actually doing the painting work on those little bits, and that way we'll have a nice clean space slate to start with. For right now, though, just want to focus on the skulls. Not really concerned about the wood areas at all. I can get them dirty, I can paint over them, I can paint them purple. Doesn't really matter. Because we will get to them later. You know, after that last video, deciding how to paint the armor on this guy, I am really excited about getting to the armor. That's going to be a fun set of time working on this guy. On that armor specifically. That's going to be a blast. But we'll have to wait. Can't jump ahead. I mean, I suppose I could, but it would be more beneficial for me to do the all this extra stuff that's sort of out of the way, first of all. So I've got that color down. Now let's switch over and add a little of this to it. And we'll start transitioning towards a bone color. Let's just see what color this produces here once I mix it up. I'll just mix it up with my dry brush. It's not that big a deal. I was looking around for my mixing brush, but it is nowhere in sight, so I'll use my dry brush and hope for the best. That's not bad. Produces sort of a tan color. Okay. I want to scrub it out a little more than that. All right. Something fell. Don't know what it was. All right. So basically, just going to keep on going over. This is actually almost, not necessarily just a flesh or a tan color. It's almost like a flesh color. But it works really, really well. Or it's working really, really well. And so that's a good thing. It's always best when the colors that you mix up tend to actually function well for what you've mixed them for. In the past, there have been times when I've mixed up a color for a model and put it on the miniature and thought, oh, good Lord, what did I just do? And then I have to go back and repaint it the previous color, which a lot of times I've already, you know, exhausted my paint supply of, and so I've got to figure out a way to remix that previous color, and it just becomes a tedious, very annoying process. So it's good when things work out the first time. All right. There we go. Nice and easy. Okay, so you can see we're kind of moving towards a bonish appearance for the skulls. We'll get there. I figure maybe two or three more highlights and we'll be at a nice solid bone color. I'm not doing in this video what I refer to as perfect bone. Normally, that's the way I paint almost all of my bone color, is using what I call perfect bone. If you're interested in learning how to do that, check out the Let's Paint Skeletons DVD set. I go through very extensively how to create perfect bone, and it is probably the best bone color you're ever going to see. It's about an 8-layer process, but you put it on a tabletop and your friends will be very, very impressed. Just a little shameless self-promotion there. But I think it's a really, really good DVD set, especially if you're a newer painter. It's probably one of the easiest sets I have to follow. In fact, there's, I think, either 8 or 10 different ways to paint bone in that DVD set, and two of them literally require one color. And it's very, very simplistic. So if you're painting a skeleton army, like the Tomb Kings or an undead or something like that, or if you're working with some mantic skeletons or any of the other various skeletons out there, or even just various bony things, bone dragons and things like that, it's a great, great DVD set to check out. Highly recommend it. Not just because it's mine, but because you're going to actually learn some stuff, which is a claim some DVDs cannot make. But anyway, there's a section in there called Perfect Bone, and it's a bone recipe, or sort of grouping of recipes that I've been using for years, and it creates one of the nicest looking bone effects I've ever seen. This is sort of a sped up version of it, but, somewhat similar, but definitely not exactly the same. But you can see we're definitely getting toward the bone color now. Okay, tap that brush out. Wipe all the water out of it. A lot of people will tell you you don't have to rinse your brush out if you're doing dry brushing. I find that to be a load of crap. If your colors are mixing on your brush, you're getting... Honestly, what you're getting is you're getting a darker color than you really should have. Because there's still so much of that previous color on your brush that you cannot rely on the color that you mixed on your palette to look exactly like it is mixed on your palette, because you've still got some of that previous color in your brush, and it can really darken the color down, make them dull and lifeless, and it's just not a good practice. It's always a good practice, no matter what you're doing, whether it's dry brushing or layering or anything, rinse your brush out between colors, okay? It's just a good habit to get into. It doesn't take that long. It doesn't take that much effort or work. And it will save you a lot of time and a lot of headache in trying to figure out why your miniatures are so dark compared to what's actually on your palette. Okay, there we go. Things are getting quick now. You're getting quick. So I'm going to switch highlight colors and rip the latex off of the eyedropper bottle of this one, because it's sort of dried up a little bit. All right. Some of that on the palette there. And mix that sucker in there. Probably a little too light, but I'm going to dry brush very lightly, so should be okay. Scrub that brush out. A little more, scrub it out again. Okay. There we go. Now we're turning towards the white side. Alright. It's starting to really, really look like a nice bone. Tops. Pick up a little bit more of this in my brush. There we go. Okay. just a little bit more of that out. But you can see, let me get rid of a little of the light. I mean, can I do it from this side? I'm not used to doing it with my left hand. I'll do it with my right hand in just a second. Hang on. Alright. Get rid of a little of the light so you guys can kind of see some of the shadows and the highlights taking place there. Okay, very, very cool. Alright, so let me get a little bit more color, a little bit lighter color, and mix that in, and then I think this will be our last highlight. So, just mix this in very quickly. Alright. And scrub it out. Left more paint in the brush this time. I think it's working a little better. I think I've been taking out a little too much. Okay. Make sure to get each side very gently. There we go. Not quite sure yet what I'm going to do with these pustules that are like on each one of the the skulls here. I see them little dots on the tops of the skulls there. I'll probably end up going somehow painting them sort of a greenish color, but I'm not quite sure how I'm going to do that yet. I will cross that bridge at a later time. For right now, though, what I would like to do is I'd like to do the eyes. So let me put this color away. My mid-tone color's already up. So let me grab some white, and we're gonna use some stark white for the eyes, because I love doing that for skeletons. Just a little of that on the palette. Put that back in its spot, and I'm gonna grab a brush here, regular brush, and just pick up a little bit of this in my brush. And we'll just dab that right there, and if I can get to it, right there. Okay, very, very cool. You can see those two guys have these really, really bright eyeballs in their skulls. Okay, so now what I've got to do is I've got to rebase coat some of the wood colors. So let me set my dry brush equipment to the side and get out my wood color again. So let's use this color and a little bit of black mixed together. Actually, that's not right. I need the other color. Where's that? There we go. And black. Okay, so let me just drip a little of this onto my palette. Was a lot of this, not a little bit. At some point, I'm going to learn not to waste paint, but I haven't quite made it to that point yet. Okay. About 2 to 1, maybe. And I need my mixing brush, which will be up here. And get some water. And just mix that dude together. Brush out. Okay. Now, let me grab a different paintbrush because the one I used to dot the eyeballs is rather small. And we'll get this taken care of. Let's go one size up. Go from a size 00 to a size 0. Or a size 0 to a size 1, sorry. Alright. This in my brush, and I'm going to repaint everything that got hit with the bone color. Okay, so I gotta paint this stick underneath this part of the skull. There we go. think the rest of the sticks are fine. Except for that one right there. I guess I just missed that. Okay. And then we'll do the little spiky bits. The horns here. I would rather do this as wood color. I don't see it being like an actual bony horn. I guess it could be. But to me, in my mind, I'm seeing these skulls, as nurglish as they are in their appearance with these little pustules on the skulls themselves, I'm seeing them more as trophies than I am as some sort of Nurgle decoration that may have mutated and actually grown horns. I suppose either one would be fine, but that's the way I'm sort of viewing this narrative of the miniature. Do whatever you want to, though, remember? As Bob Ross used to say, it's your world, you can do what you want. Just make it your own. Although I'm not 100% sure how Bob Ross would feel about, you know, painting a vile, corrupted Nurgle character. I don't know if he would fall into the same category as Happy Little Clouds, or Happy Little Lakes, or Happy Little Anything. He might, though. I don't know. Do not know. Okay. Well, I've got a string on the end of my brush. Let me get rid of that, because it's very, very annoying. Okay, there we go. Problem solved. I suppose if you were to look at these skulls as actual, you know, mutated Nurgle items, and it's just some sort of maybe heads of former, you know, Nurgle knights or something. I don't freaking know. You know, it might work like that, and you'd have bone or horns coming out of the skulls, but I just don't see it that way. There we go. We're going to rinse that brush out. And I think what I'm going to do here, we're probably going to go a little bit over the 20-minute mark, because I'd like to get this wood stuff done today. Let's go ahead and break here. And I tell you what, no, because I've got a lot of base coating work to do, and so that'll kind of give us something to break up some of the little bits of base coating in the next video. So we'll break here. And we'll finish off the wood next time, in addition to base coating all of the armor and get that moving. By the way, I'm just dusting the miniature. I see some little bits of things, with little specks of dust on various areas. So I like to use this big, soft, fluffy brush here just to kind of dust the model off if I see things like that. But for right now, we'll call it a day. I got some pretty good work there done on the skulls, and we'll come in next time. We'll finish up this little bit of wood here at the back, and I'll start base coating out the armor, and that will give us the bulk of the miniature. There's going to be a lot of little small details all over the model, but once we get the armor done, we'll have a huge, huge chunk of this miniature finished, and at that point, for the most part, it's going to be a lot of detail work, just picking out little bits and bobs here and there. But for right now, we will call it a day. So I appreciate you guys watching. Thank you very, very much. If you happen to have any comments or questions, please leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. Again, thank you for watching. God bless you all. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I'll see you all in the next video.